What is poppin', ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages? It is your boy Mikey JTV in the mother of a place to be. And today, we're going to just be doing some sort of account overview, I guess. I just hit AR50, so I wanted to show you guys my progress and everything that's going on with the account, everything that I've been doing. I know I've been a little on and off with the, you know, the uploads or whatever, but hey, it is what it is. But that does not mean I haven't been grinding on my account. I've literally been doing the opposite. I've been putting a lot of hours in this account, and I know I should stream it. I gotta do better on that. I'm gonna do better. First of all, I want to tell you guys, I will not be summoning on the 1.2 banners. Main reason is because one, Albedo and Ganyu really don't interest me. I already have like a Geo unit in the Traveler, and he's also a sword user. So it's just like, I really don't need it. And I pulled Zhongli. So, I mean, those two pretty much cover what I want in my Geo units. Cryo Bow, Ganyu. I mean, we just got Diona. I C6'd her. I know she's not, I think Ganyu's, I really haven't even looked at what Ganyu does, but I do believe that she's more damage oriented rather than defense. But even still, I don't need another bow user because I have Child and he's great, which segues me into the next little conversation of topic. He will be my first level 90 character. I have just a few more materials to get him ascended. I need three of these. And if anybody has done the level 90 grind, you know that these are the hardest things to get. So almost done with that. Almost done. Just got to get three more, and that's that. Now, people might ask, hey, Mikey, why aren't you summoning? Because I want to get Xiao. Xiao will probably be my next big project. Zhongli was the one before, so I had most of the materials to get him to 80 and all that kind of stuff. So 80 is really the sweet spot, really the goal of where I want to be with the characters that I invest in the most. If you guys remember my last video, I was talking about how Jinyan wasn't going to be the star of the video because I couldn't get all the things. I took a day and I got some ascension, some XP materials to level her up and see exactly where, you know, the potential that she could have. I really do like her. I would like to invest more in the future, but not right now. My main, I'm usually building three characters at once, and most people would argue that that's way too many. You probably want to, and I absolutely agree, you probably want to focus on maybe two at a time, if not just one. But I'm at a point in the game where I'm pretty much everywhere. I want to try everything, and it's very, very confusing, and it's very it's very resource heavy. But Kaching is one of the characters that I just took a sudden interest in because I see a lot of videos with Kaching, and I really, really, I like the way that I like her play style. I like the way she moves. I like her damage output, and damage output was one of the things that I couldn't get her to do. So I decided, I think like last week or something, to just start paying more attention to Kaching, and slowly and surely I was able to, you know, get some decent artifacts on her. I pulled a Thunder Soother goblet, and it was miraculously electro damage bonus. The subs are absolute trash, unfortunately. So when I'm looking to get more artifacts, I'll definitely, if I get like a 5-star drop with electro damage bonus and some nice subs, it doesn't matter if it's Thunder Soother or not, I'll replace this one with a 5-star one, because that'll just boost her damage even more for when she does her E and her ult. I got really lucky with this one. Like I say, not too good on the sub stats, but the attack bonus on the Thunder Soother, not too bad at all. Not too bad at all. For the crown, she's using Gladiator. I put crit rate on her because that's pretty much her whole kit. Like her kit really shines off of her crits, and that's where her big damage comes from. So moving on to Child and where he's at right now, I'm looking to get this huge boost from his ascension. So he goes from 68 to 75% hydro bonus damage. That's huge. That's really good. That's what I'm looking at right now. He already does a ton of damage, and he already is, you know, he's my go-to whenever I need to clear something. He was a very huge part in farming for his artifacts, which is pretty good. I did luck up and get a 4-star geo bonus damage goblet for him. But I'm going more of the HP build. I did have an HP helmet on him. I think it was this one here. Yeah, I had this HP helmet on him. It did roll in defense, which is pretty good for Zhang Li, since he's going to be, I'm using him as more of a support, but I want to try out different builds on him, you know, just to test the waters and all that kind of stuff. So, but I will be mainly using him as support, which he does like a decent amount of damage. He does what I want him to do. He provides survivability for the team, and he also gives me the crystals. I have him on Petra set, so I use him in conjunction with Ka-Ching, and when she does her elemental things, she gets that bonus damage when she picks up the electro crystals. So I do some critical thinking when I put these teams together and what I want these characters to do. But thinking about Xiao in the future, he's definitely going to be he's obviously DPS, so I'm thinking I want to do Gladiator unless something better comes out besides Gladiator. I'll definitely have an artifact set for Gladiator all ready to go when he drops. I have some of his you know things. I've just started farming this today, so I only got 10 of these, but he's going to be taking these. So this is from the Child event. I already have two, so I will not be using this on anyone else until I get, you know, I get Xiao carried out. I started on the stones, so I definitely gonna have one. I need 9 and 9 of these, so half of that's done. Obviously he's gonna need 6 of the big stones. I don't have any right now, but I think until February, if he drops in February, then, you know, I should have that too good to go by then. The last thing I'm going to do is farm for his talents. Man, I really need to get on talent farming, because it's such a big part of the game. And the highest talent character I have actually is Zhang Li. So I had most of his because nobody that I use has had his talent books used. So that was very fortunate for me. Ka-Ching's weapon, I went ahead and did the pass weapon for that. For the next couple months, I'll probably just be getting that for her refine. It's a very good weapon and gives crit rate, and base attack is pretty decent once you get it up to level 90. But yeah, this is probably the best weapon for her as of right now. 9 times out of 10, before Xiao releases, we'll probably get a better weapon for her. I'm not sure. Definitely when we get to Inazuma, we'll probably have a bunch of electro style weapons to facilitate that. But yeah, I think that's pretty much all I wanted to share with you guys today. No gameplay for real. Save your resin. Just save your resin for future events. That's what I'm going to be doing. I probably went a little too hard getting those books for Zhang Yin. So, man, I really want to build her. Like, I'm still on the fence of, you know, putting Ka-Ching to the wayside, because she's fine where she's at, but any character obviously can be more better, but I kind of want to focus on Zhang Yin, bro. I can't with these names, but y'all know who I'm talking about. Daluk, man, my boy Daluk here. He has seen better days. When I got Child, I put everything that I had into Child, and he just does tremendous damage to the point where it's just like, Daluk who? And I really hate to say it, but once I do build, if I build Jin Yan, she's definitely replacing Diluc, unfortunately. It's not like he's bad. It's just that Jin Yan has so much more utility and she does less damage than him, but that her utility makes up for it way more than Diluc. But anyway, like I said, this is just an update video of, you know, where I'm at with my account, where you should be. You should be, you know, also don't. I thought it was a myth. I knew it wasn't a good thing to do, but I wanted to farm more materials from the Oceanid. And I thought, you know, maybe if I just increase my world level, I'll get better drops. No, you just don't. You don't get better drops. That's just not a thing. So anyway, I increased my world level. Please don't do that when you hit level 50. Wait until you have at least one level 90 character before you do that. Like I say, I'm cool where I'm at with my damage. I can still, you know, take out mobs, no problem. It's just a bigger hassle to farm with not a better reward. So don't do that world level mission until you're absolutely ready, until you're in a comfortable spot to where you can you can go through the world comfortably. Like I say, I can, but it's a little bit tougher, but it kind of evens itself out because you do get better drops from mobs. I just have yet to see getting better drops from elite monsters and bosses. So I really hope they do change that, because I feel like that's kind of clickbaity on them. But yeah, anyway, I'm gonna stop boring you guys. We will have some gameplay videos I want to do some domain videos, because a lot of people are having trouble with domain videos or domains, and I want to help out with those. So I'll probably put up some domain videos, level 90, level 80, whichever you want, because farming for 5-star artifacts is absolutely terrible, especially when you're on the wrong side of RNG and those ice mages, they just gang up on you and you just die instantly. So I want to put out a video helping with that and all that kind of stuff. So stay tuned in the future. If you guys enjoyed today's video, if you guys, you know, like these little talks and, you know, going over what's happening, where you should be and all that kind of stuff. If you're excited for Xiao, go ahead and put that down in the comment section below. Let me know what you guys are doing in your accounts right now. Now that Zhongli is out and we're about to go into 1.2 Dragon Spine, which I will make another video on. I really want to talk about all of that. But before I did that, I wanted to, you know, address you guys and let you know exactly what I was doing, what I was going through and all that kind of stuff. But anyway, I'm going to get up on out of here. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you have not already, comment, like, subscribe, all that stuff. And peace.